Greetings, friends. Sonic Toast here, and guess what? We're doing something a little bit different today. I know this channel is like almost 100% all about Sonic and Mario, but I thought we'll do something completely different this time, right? We're gonna do a Star Wars video. Holy cranberries, what the heck's going on? Star Wars? Well, it's really popular right now because the new movie comes out really soon, and so this is something that I have actually always been a fan about, but since my channel's just about Sonic and Mario, I've always done Sonic and Mario videos, but this is me kind of trying to expand my horizons, kind of do something a little bit different, and that's why we are going to do Star Wars. Don't worry, I am still working on my Halloween special, but my computer is still broken that has the file that I was editing it on. So once I can get a new computer, I will finish that Halloween special. It might not even be until like Christmas that I have my Halloween special done. So sorry about that, but I'm working on it. But until then, let's enjoy Star Wars. Let's get hyped for Star Wars. You might say I'm a bandwagoner, but seriously, I've always loved Star Wars. How can I prove it? Well, look, I even wore my Jar Jar Binks tie to work today. Under a sweater, of course, but I still wore a Jar Jar Binks tie to work. And seriously, I always loved Star Wars. The original Star Wars. When I was like in 8th grade, Star Wars Episode 1 came out, and I loved it! I loved Episode 1! And then, 3 years later, Episode 2 came out, and I don't know if maybe it's because I was older, or maybe because Episode 2 was just terrible, but that's kind of where I fell out of love with Star Wars. I mean, Star Wars was like rivaled with Sonic for my favorite franchises. Star Wars and Sonic were like my two things. Mario was like number three down here, but like after Episode 2, Star Wars, my love for Star Wars kind of died down, and Mario became my rival with Sonic. True story, true story. So that's when I kind of stopped buying Star Wars toys. And so you'll see all my toys are all from the original trilogy and all from Episode 1. I've got two figures from Episode 2 in here somewhere. And I have a lot of Star Wars toys. So look, I've got this R2-D2 carrying case full of Star Wars figures. I have a C-3PO carrying case full of Star Wars figures, and it talks.
Hi, I'm C-3PO.
Human-cyborg relations, right? And then I got this a Millennium Falcon carrying case full of Star Wars figures, and another Millennium Falcon carrying case full of Star Wars figures. And then here is the actual Millennium Falcon toy, which is also full of Star Wars figures. And then, oh yes, and I have my Ninja Turtle lunchbox, which, as you would guess, is also full of Star Wars figures. And then on top of that, I have a plastic bag, which is also full of Star Wars figures. So, we're gonna go through them, and you're gonna get to see my whole collection of Star Wars figures, and we'll see if I can still remember all of their names, as I have not been a super Star Wars enthusiast over the last few years, but I still love Star Wars. So, Toast, let's get started. Okay, so this is the area where we'll be placing the figures. I'm gonna try to go fast, because we got a lot. So, we're starting with my Ninja Turtle lunchbox full of figures, and we'll start with this dude, the Snitch, Grindin. If you can see him, there we go. There is Grindin. Alright, next, the Rancor Keeper, Malakili. And Momonadin, the Hammerheaded Ithorian from the Mos Eisley Cantina. And speaking of the Cantina, here's the bartender, Wooer. And everybody loves Muftak. Oh, I'm so happy I am remembering their names. And everybody knows this guy, Chewbacca. Sorry, terrible impression. It is Salacious Crumb. And then we got Obi-Wan Kenobi, you're my only hope. And oh, I can't remember this dude's real name. Whoops, I hit the camera. This is Snaggletooth. Snaggletooth is sort of his unofficial name. I forget what his official name is, though. Ponda Baba. And Lackey Servacky, or actually Lack Servac. Kervis Cal backwards. But I was going to Tashi Station to pick up some power converters. So there's a lot of Luke Skywalkers in this collection. This is a Luke Skywalker that came in a 3-pack with C-3PO and Uncle Owen. Shoot. Can't remember this dude's name. I just call him Bluehead. And oh, I love this dude. He's a sideburns guy who tells Obi-Wan to talk to Chewbacca. What is his name? It's like Odie or something? Garfield and Odie? Anyway, that's him. And Dr. Avazin? He doesn't like you. I don't like you either. This is Cabe. And here's a Jawa.
Teeny.
And this is the band. I'll just hold them all up. So here's, they're all the same figure, but They are poseable enough to all hold different instruments. Do I remember all the band members' name? The head of the band is Frigrin Dan, Tech, Tedden, Doiknats, and Nolan.
And Jabba's Palace type alien guys right here. Chewbacca's will go here. I don't think I have too many Chewbacca's. Obi-Wan Kenobi's will go here. Don't have a ton of Obi-Wans either. More aliens. Aliens for breakfast. Alright, I'll put Salacious Crumb up here because he's small. Alright, there we go. There's Ponda. Lackey Serbacky. Anus. There we go. Try to do this quick. Now Luke Skywalker's. I'll put Luke Skywalker's. Not Han Solo's can go there. Luke Skywalker's will go right here.
Okie dokie, so that is round one of eight.
Now, round two.
Let's see, these are just some different figures and creatures. Two probe droids. Okay. I guess this is a little tiny Count Dooku, I think that is. Here is a Tauntaun. And I think this is Luke Skywalker's Tauntaun. And this one is Han Solo's Tauntaun. The Wampa.
Now these are all Power of the Force
figures from like 1997, 98, 99, that time period. Oh, this is the Ronto from Star Wars Special Edition. The Rancor from Jabba's Palace. The Bantha. Here is Jabba the Hutt from Star Wars Special Edition. Here is Jabba the Hutt from Return of the Jedi, even though he came in a Star Wars Episode 1 box. This is not how he looked in Star Wars Episode 1. I think they made an actual figure of him from Episode 1, but I never got that. And here is that dinosaur thing that Jar Jar rides on. This is the first of the big fish from Star Wars Episode 1. There's always a big fish. Well, shoot, you know what? I just realized I totally left my Dubac at work. I don't believe it. Like, Dubacs, like, everyone at work is just obsessed with Dubacs. You know, the big lizards that the stormtroopers ride on? So, yeah. I totally had my Dubac at work, and I totally forgot it. Makes me mad that of all creatures, I forgot the Dubac. I tell you, I'm going to be the laughing stock of the office for having a Star Wars video with no Dubac in it. Golly. Golly gee. Shucky dang darn. Oh well. Hope you all can forgive me for not having a Dubac in my video. I know my coworkers certainly won't. Come on, probe droid. There we go. And this probe droid. You can never have too many probe droids, right? And Jar Jar's dinosaur. I forget what they're called. I don't know the names of the Episode 1 creatures as well. Because I didn't grow up with them as much as I did with the older movie characters. Alright, on to round 3. These will be the figures that are inside this plastic bag. Okay, like I said, we're doing 8 rounds of this. So here is this dude, forget his name, but he sits in the corner at Jabba's Palace. And here is Lando in his skiff guard disguise. Oops, I just hit the camera. Lando in his skiff guard disguise. I'm Lando! Alright, this isn't a Power of the Force figure. It's just a funny Jar Jar figure. He's so funny, but he doesn't count. Anyway, moving on. Alright, here is a AT-ST driver. It's a Weekoi skiff guard. An Imperial tool. Imperial worker commander. Maybe. I don't remember exactly. Here's Jar Jar. This is the Jar Jar that rides on the dinosaur thing. Okay, so this is Droopy McCool from Jabba's Palace. This is actually the old one from the 80s. This is not the Power of the Force one from the 90s, like from all the other figures I have here. This is an old one, and I, you know, just couldn't get a hold of the one for the figures that I collect. It was really rare, so I ended up just getting this old one at Comic-Con, and he still looks good, so there we go. Toast. This is one of the Emperor's Royal Guards from Return of the Jedi. Here is Bib Fortuna. So I used to be so obsessed with Star Wars that I wrote a song about Bib Fortuna. It was to the tune of My Sharona. Bib Fortuna. Here's Han Solo, trapped in carbonite. This is Max Rebo. So this is one, this is actually from this set of figures. Like one of the only band members I was able to get. This is Bossk, one of the bounty hunters. Very cool. This is Ishi Tib. Smells like fish, tastes like ice cream. If you get that reference, you are the best. And Ephraim Mom, I don't remember his name exactly, but yep, here he is. This is one humongous action figure. And here's another Skiff Guard. I forget what this guy's name is. Bubble Face or something. All right, here's another Skiff Guard. I don't remember his name. And who else is in here? Here's another Weekoi Skiff Guard. I got two of these. All right. Ah, everyone knows this dude. This is Boba Fett. Here is Dengar, another bounty hunter. R2-D2. Very cool. This is the desert R2-D2 figure. You can see he's got desert dust on him. This is C-3PO. I think this is removable arm C-3PO. Yes, from some point in the movies where he lost his arm. I don't remember exactly when. I think it's when the Tusken Raiders attacked. He loses his arm. Another C-3PO toy. Now, this one is in pieces, but it's not supposed to be. This is the C-3PO that came in a three-pack with Luke and Uncle Owen. And, yeah, it's the purchase of the droids three-pack. You can see he's got his little restraining bolt on him. So, anyway, this is Greedo, one of my favorite characters. Yeah, I just love Greedo. Here is Luke Skywalker in his Jedi outfit from Return of the Jedi. And we're almost done with this bag. Here's another alien from Jabba's Palace. Looks sort of like Frankenstein. I forget what this character's name is. There's Princess Leia in her Boosh disguise. Bounty Hunter. She looks better with the mask on. Jar Jar Binks with no ear. This one's not even mine. This is my friend's from work. I guess he just got mixed up with my figures somehow. But here's another Jar Jar with his tongue sticking out and his ears are ripped off. A droid. Do you see in the background? Multiple shots in the old movies. And this is Omar Monk. He was in Jabba's Palace. He's the one that chases 3PO in to the palace. Quite the story behind him. I think he was a Star Wars Insider exclusive figure. So I was really excited to get him. But of course, sure enough, a few days after he came, my dog chewed up one of his legs. So one of his legs falls off easily. Alrighty, let's get moving. We got a lot to stack here. Let's see. Got lots more aliens to do. Ooh, Landos. Let's put Landos here. Put the Empire on the end here. Boss can go with aliens and stuff. Oof. They're like dominoes. All better. This big guy we'll put over here with the other big guys. Don't want too many big guys, right? Ishi-Tib, go right there. Ishi-Tib always makes me hungry for Tri-Tip just because of his name. It's that dude. Imperial guy. More Jabba's friends. We'll just start putting them over here near Jabba. Jabba the Hutt. Jar Jar, you can ride your dinosaur. There you go. There's another Jar Jar. Alrighty. Bib Fortuna. Bib Fortuna. Hey! And this is Boba Fett. Kudos if you know where that line's from. R2-D2. We're gonna put R2-D2's right here, front and center. Bomar Monk. We'll put you here, Bomar Monk. Alright, Han Solo's. Droid can go here. Weekoi Skiff Guard here. C-3PO, human-cyborg relations. You can go right here next to Master Luke. Okay, so there's all those. I'm not sure how far we got into it before it stopped recording, but there they are set up. Let's move on to the next set. Let's do R2 Daytona. So these are figures inside of the R2-D2 carrying case, which, it's very stiff. It's like a playset and carrying case all rolled into one. Alrighty, so let's see who we got in here. First off, this lady, she's one of the dancers in the special edition of Jabba's Palace. And this is a sand trooper. Look, sir, droids. And another sand trooper. And this is Greta, another one of the dancers. And here is another sand trooper. And this is that box droid who always just shows up. No! And this is a Gamorrean guard. If you want to know his name, I think this is Gartog. And this is EV99 from Jabba's Palace. And this is one of the special edition band members in Jabba's Palace. He's Rodian. Yak Face. This is one of my favorites because, seriously, he looks like Ryan Stiles. And this is Ula, the dancer who gets dropped down into the Rancor pit. Here is Princess Leia as Jabba's slave, Slave Leia. Although, since it got bought out by Disney, I think they're not allowed to call her Slave Leia anymore. I think she's just called, like, Jabba's Prisoner Leia or something. Sice Noodles. Again, this is not the 97-98 Power of the Force Sice Noodles. This is like the 80s version of Sice Noodles, which I was just able to find at Comic-Con because the 90s version is just too rare, I guess. Another one of Jabba's dancers is Han Solo, fresh from the Carbonite. Another Jabba skiff guard, his name is Barada, Pruneface. Another Jedi Luke Skywalker, this is the one that came with the Rancor. Is another Greedo, this one is much better than one we were showing before. Un tan solo, son pinchole, narabasca, Jabba. Okay, here's Chewbacca as prisoner from Jabba's palace. He's got the chain on his neck. And here's the 8D8 droid who tortures other droids in Jabba's palace. All right, that's round four.
So, we'll put Greedo. Here's the newer Greedo. The band Greedo. To go through all these toys again. These toys that I haven't played with for years. They've just been boxed up for so long. Ever since I had to grow up. Ever since episode 2. I say grow up, that means I just moved on to Sonic and Mario. Alright. Prune Face! Okay, moving on.
All right, so I want to say we're about halfway through, but the truth is, there's a whole lot more to do. So, let's hurry up and get this done. All right, next we're doing the biggest one, the C-3PO carrying case. I'll just meet you there, are you? All right, so, let's see if I can show you how big this carrying case is. It has so many figures that they all fall out when you open it up. Okay, so here's a Jedi, I forget her name, Addy Zebra something. That's her, she's from episode 1, well, from the prequels in general. I think she died in the Clone Wars. Here's Luke Skywalker. This is Luke Skywalker that came with binoculars and a Gilligan hat. He was from a deleted scene. This is Pilot Luke Skywalker. And this is Smuggler Han Solo, so not even from the movies, but he came with this big giant backpack. This is Luke Skywalker. From the garbage chute after he gets pulled underneath right by the Dianoga. See how his hair is supposed to be wet? I can show you there is another one. Oh wait, no, never mind. This isn't it. This is just a regular stormtrooper. I was wrong. This is Luke Skywalker in stormtrooper disguise. So this is him when his hair is dry before he gets pulled down by the Dianoga. Here is the deluxe Luke Skywalker. His pants are slightly tanner than the regular Luke Skywalker. Let me see. Okay, that one's not in this box. Here's another Luke Skywalker. What's special about this one? I don't remember. Oh, I think this is Luke Skywalker that came with a little toy airplane, you know, T-16 Skyhopper that he plays with while he's talking to C-3PO. That's what's different about this one. This is Luke Skywalker in his Dagobah fatigues when he's training with Master Yoda. And here is Luke Skywalker in his Hoth gear, and he's all bloody from the Wampa monster that slashed him in the face. This one came with a Wampa. Here's Han Solo. This is a cool Han Solo from the Cantina, specifically the scene where he shoots Greedo, so he's got his hand like when it's on the wall. And next up,
This is Darth Vader. This is the Darth Vader that can sit down. He's special because his top helmet comes off, but just the top helmet.
Next up,
this is little Anakin Skywalker. Yippee!
And,
ooh, one of my favorite bounty hunters, IG-88.
Next up,
this is Deluxe Boba Fett. Like the Han Solo, this came with a giant backpack.
And this is Yoda.
This is a second edition Yoda that has real hair, and he came with more accessories than the first edition of Yoda. This is a Pit Droid. Hey, tap the nose!
And
this is another kind of Pit Droid. Here is the first Emperor Palpatine of this collection of figures. Wipe them out, all of them. Oh, my favorite Viceroy, Rune Hecko! Is that legal? Here's one of Queen Luke Skywalker when he's sitting in the gunner seat of the Millennium Falcon. And here is Luke Skywalker when he removes the restraining bolt off of R2-D2. Yeah, they made a Luke figure for like every single scene he's in all those movies, and like a tool, I bought them all. This is the mouse droid from the Death Star. And this is an AT-AT commander from the AT-AT Walker, Battle of Hoth. This is a regular stormtrooper. And this is Mace Windu, little Anakin Skywalker wearing his helmet. This is Dash Rendar from Shadows of the Empire. He's made popular by an N64 game. This is the first edition of Han Solo, who is overly buff. I'm really buff Han Solo. This dude, I don't remember his name. He's not in any of the movies. He's from like a video game or something. It's some kind of crazy droid. Oh, is this? This is Wedge. Wedge Antilles, the Rebel pilot. Biggs Darklighter, another Rebel pilot. This was the one that was Luke's friend. Mon Mothma, the one other woman in the entire galaxy. Here's Han Solo wearing this pilot. This when he's in the gunner seat of the Millennium Falcon from that one scene. This is an A-Wing pilot, another Rebel. Ah, my favorite villain. Well, one of my favorite villains besides like Greedo. This is Grand Moff Tarkin. He is the real evil one in that first movie. A deluxe stormtrooper. He too came with a big backpack, like Han Solo and Boba Fett. This is Han Solo in stormtrooper disguise. Yay, Han. This one is a Rebel fleet trooper. And this is dear sweet Aunt Beru. So sad to think about what happened to her. This is the AT-AT driver. And it's a trap! Admiral Ackbar! Forlom, another one of the bounty hunters from Empire Strikes Back. Here's Luke from Empire Strikes Back again in his Hoth gear. This is just the regular Hoth Luke. Here's Han Solo from Empire Strikes Back wearing a felt jacket. And here is Han Solo again from Empire Strikes Back, except this time his jacket is hard plastic. Yeah. Here is Return of the Jedi Leia from the Ewok Village. And here she is again with plastic clothes. This one has like cloth clothes. Yeah, I do feel like a tool on how many of these I bought. Here's Leia in her Hoth gear. Okay, here's Bespin Leia, again with the cloth clothes. Here is another regular Han Solo. This one came in a pack with Jabba the Hutt, special edition Jabba the Hutt. This is Luke Skywalker as an Imperial guard of some kind from Shadows of the Empire. I read that book and played that video game. I just don't remember it too well. Here's Princess Leia, like the classic Leia, but with cloth clothes. And who's next? Here's a guy from a Star Wars video game. His name is Kyle. I don't remember what game he's from exactly. Here is a Endor Rebel Trooper. Here is a battle droid from Star Wars Episode 1 that rides some kind of a tank or something. This is Wicket W. Warwick, the Ewok. Yeecha! And this is Queen Amidala from Star Wars Episode 1. This is 2-1-B.
exhausted, yet we have three more sets to do. Now we're going to open up the Millennium Falcon toy, which is stuffed with figures, and start adding these to the collection. So, first, we got... This is the Destroyer Droid from Episode 1. Prince Shizor from Star Wars The Shadows of the Empire. There's Emperor Palpatine that can shoot lightning. It's one of the electric figures. Here's a lightsaber firing R2-D2 from Return of the Jedi. Here's Queen Amidala. And this is a Tusken Raider. This is the Episode 1 version of the Tusken Raider. Here's R2-D2 that rolls. I think that's from Episode 1. Here's Hoth Chewbacca covered in snow. Here's another Jedi Luke. This is a Jedi Luke that came in a 3-pack with Emperor Palpatine and Darth Vader, and he could hold his lightsaber with two hands. Here is the Darth Vader that goes in that set, who could also hold his lightsaber in two hands. Here is one of the droids from Queen Amidala's ship in Episode 1 that gets blasted off again. This is just the regular R2-D2 from the first set of these figures. Here is Uncle Owen from the 3-pack with Luke and C-3PO. And here is Watto. Nubian, eh? And here is Chancellor Valorum from Episode 1. So many old men don't do anything. Alright, here's an Ewok from the old 80s figures. Which I guess got mixed up with these figures. So yay, another Ewok. Here's Zuckuss, Bounty Hunter. This is Logre, another Ewok. This is the Death Star droid. What's up? I am TC-14. And this is Emperor Palpatine from the 3-pack, where he sits down. Here is Ceremonial Princess Leia. Here's Princess Leia, just a traditional one. You can hold a gun with two hands. And here is just the regular C-3PO from the first set of figures. Here is Atu-De-Towa, the stuff that you can plug into him. And this is, what is his name? Rick Oley. Rick Oley, the pilot from Episode 1. Another R2-D2. This is one that has little booster things that come out of him. Alright, who's next? R5-D4. This R2 unit has a bad motivator. And here's another Ewok. This is the hang gliding Ewok. I think he died in the movie. And here is another Ewok. This is Wicket W. Warwick once again. This is Darth Maul, just regular Darth Maul. Here's Episode 1 Yoda. And this is Darth Sidious from Episode 1, who becomes Emperor Palpatine. And here is the Spirit of Obi-Wan Kenobi. This is a special one because to get this figure, you had to send in proofs of purchase from 2 bags of Lay's potato chips, like the big party size bags. So I remember buying the bags and taking them over to a friend's house. We just had a movie night where we just ate Lay's potato chips all night so that I could order my Obi-Wan Kenobi figure. And this is another Ewok. This is, I think, is this the chief Ewok? What's his name? Like Tebow or something like that? Anyway, toast. And here is an Ugnaught from Cloud City. Ugly little fella, isn't he? Focus. So we can see how ugly you are. There we go. Alright, there's the ugly Ugnaught. Alright, because I'm so tired, we're just going to move on to the first Millennium Falcon carrying case. So, these cases carry a lot of figures also. So, let's get moving with these. So, first we got a battle droid, a wiggly battle droid that rides one of their battle droid bikes or whatever. Here is Empire Strikes Back Luke Skywalker, and this one has the removable hand. Whoops, wrong hand. One of these hands comes off. I know it. There we go. Yeah. Ah, he chopped off my hand. Because I must make you understand, I'm your father. I'm your father. Alright, here's Yoda, just the first Yoda they released of Power of the Force figures in like 1996 or 7 or 5, whenever.
Anyway, here's the C-3PO. This is the one that is supposed to come apart from when he gets blown up in Empire Strikes Back. Next, we have another R2-D2. That's just the regular R2-D2. I have two of them because another one came in two-pack with Leia. Here's Emperor's friend from the prequels. Don't remember his name. We'll just call him Horny Guy. Here is Nina. It's like, what are you, a bologna sandwich? Here's the Episode 1 version of C-3PO. Here's Admiral Piet from Empire Strikes Back. Well, he dies in Return of the Jedi. Here's the first Leia figure from the first set. She looks kind of like a monkey. And here's one of my only Episode 2 figures. Anakin Skywalker from Star Wars Episode 2. So after buying that figure, I realized, yeah, I don't think I want to buy Star Wars toys anymore because I didn't really like Episode 2. Yeah, true story. Here's his arm that goes back on. Cool. Anyway, Lobot! Such a cool character. It's Lobot! Ding! Doo-doo! And here is another Ugnaught. An ugly, ugly Ugnaught. And here is Princess Leia in her Endor gear. And here is Luke Skywalker from the ceremony in the end of the first movie. Ceremonial Luke. This is a battle droid from Star Wars Episode 1. This is the Shot battle droid. And this is just the normal battle droid who has not been shot. And then this is a battle droid with red on him. I forgot what makes this one special or unique from the others. And this is Captain Panaka from Star Wars Episode 1. And this is a weird version of Jedi Luke that has a glowing lightsaber, and he wears a cape. And if you take the cape off, he's got a huge battery coming out of his back. And this is a Hoth Rebel Trooper. And this is Captain Tarples. And this is a swoop bike driver from Shadows of the Empire. And this is the FX7? Is that his name? EVFX7 droid or something like that? No. Oh, what is this dude's name? ASP droid. ASP7 droid. That's who this is. This is the ASP7 droid from Star Wars Special Edition. You can tell. It's a computer animated character. And here is Darth Maul, who gets cut in half. Here's one of my favorite Jedi, Ki-Adi-Mundi. Or Ki-Adi-Mundi, whatever you would call him. Here's Boss Nass. That's like the worst part of the prequels. I actually like Jar Jar, but I don't like Boss Nass. Here's Endor gear, Luke Skywalker. Here's another one of Queen Amidala's soldier dudes from Episode 1. Han Solo from his carbonite. And here is just the first Luke Skywalker figure. His pants are more gray than the other one that looks like this that I showed earlier. And here is the Endor gear Han Solo. And here is another Obi-Wan Kenobi, young Obi-Wan. I don't remember what is different between this one and the one that I showed earlier. Cranberry sauce. Here is Lando Calrissian. And here is Qui-Gon Jinn with his, like, scuba diving thing in his mouth. He's the one that came with the big fish. And here is just regular Qui-Gon Jinn. Alright, so that is our... Okay, guys, here we are, finally on round 8. It is the other Millennium Falcon carrying case full of figures. So, let's see who we got here. First things first, it is another one of the Emperor's Royal Guards. Why not? Here's another Emperor figure with more Force Lightning. And here is the old Anakin Skywalker, who's no longer in it because of special editions and everything. They replaced him with Hayden Christensen, but that's who he should be, in my opinion. And this is a Tusken Raider. And this is yet another Tusken Raider. And here is Lando Commando. Yeah, yeah. And here is another Hoth Luke. This one, the one that rides the Tauntaun. Here's Hoth Han Solo, who rides a Tauntaun. And here is a Snowtrooper. This is the deluxe Snowtrooper that comes with a big gun. Here is another Hoth Han Solo. And here is a Hoth Rebel Trooper. Very cool. I told you there'd be more battle droids. So here's like a jungle battle droid. And here is a slashed battle droid. And I remember this battle droid. This one is called Nine. He's yellow. Alright. We're almost done here. Almost done. Alright, so here is Vader. This was just the very first Vader they did in this set of figures. And on top of that, here is the electronic Vader, who's actually probably the most decent of all these electronic figures. That's a lie. R2-D2 is really good, and so is the Emperor. But yeah, he has the electronic glowing saber that you can connect in there. Here's another Viceroy. Yes, that is perfectly legal. Newt Gunray, that's his name, Newt Gunray. Here is Vader with the removable helmet. Here is Vader with just the top of his helmet is removable. This one came with a board game. And here is a pair of Scout Troopers that came on the speeder bikes. And then, I'll scrap this one. Here's a Scout Trooper. This is an old 80s figure Scout Trooper, which I just felt like they did a really good job on him. And at the time, these were the only ones they had with the super spread out legs. So that's why I had to get this old one just to have a normal looking Scout Trooper. True story. This is a pod racer named Audie Mandrell. And here is a TIE Fighter pilot. And here is Jango Fett, the other Episode 2 figure I have, which actually, this figure was a sneak preview Episode 2. So he came out with like all the Episode 1 figures and stuff. Like, sneak preview, this character from Episode 2, Jango Fett. Pretty cool, though. I do think he's a cool character. And here is Darth Vader. What's special about this Darth Vader? Oh, this is just the Darth Vader that's able to hold lightsaber with two hands. So that's what's special about this one. And there's also a Darth Vader that has like electricity going through his face that I never got. Here's Darth Maul wearing his hood. That's what's different about this one. Here is Senator Palpatine. And here is the Death Star Gunner. And another Snow Trooper. And I want to say we're done, but I just remembered way back in our R2-D2 carrying case, there are some little hidden drawers here that I forgot to empty. So we got in here, who is this? A Jawa. And this one, there is another Jawa. Another Jawa. And a pod racer. Alright, we're just going to move this here Jawa. And we're going to put these pod racer guys over here. There we go. Alright, this is monumental. Our last Luke Skywalker to add into the bunch. Another Hoth Luke. Three of them in total. And our last two, Han Solos, who both also happen to be Hoth Han Solos. And are also our last Lando, who is not Hoth, because we never saw Lando on the planet Hoth. So, there you go. And last but not least, actually last and probably least, because he's not even canon anymore, is Anakin Skywalker as an old man. Alrighty, and that is it. That is all of them. Holy cranberries, I am just sweating bullets here. This video has taken 3 hours to make. 3 hours I've been doing this. Holy cranberries. But I hope it was worth it. I hope you have enjoyed this video. Leave me a comment. What do you think of me not doing Sonic or Mario videos for a change? What do you think of me expanding out to other things such as Star Wars toys? Let me know in the comments section. So that is my full Star Wars action figure collection, except for, of course, the Dewback, which I mentioned, is missing. But besides the Dewback, that is all of my Star Wars toys. Let me know if you want to see a collection of my Star Wars vehicles, ships, and everything like that. Thanks for watching. Toast!